Italian cuisine is Italy's gift to the world. From top to toe, the map of Italy is a patchwork of gastronomic treasures that come not from a tradition of great chefs, but from beloved family recipes. Italy is the home of slow food, and Italian cuisine is largely about regional cooking. From one region to the next, produce, recipes, and traditions vary. Labels like DOP, DOCG, and IGP guarantee that certain products are harvested from a specific area and made by local farmers and artisans. But labels aside, the essence of Italian cuisine is in its simplicity. In how a few modest ingredients can come together to create something magical. And this is what keeps us coming back for more. Do come and join me. Let's get to know the people behind the produce. Let's step inside Italian kitchens. Let's eat the best of Italy from top to toe. I'm Margarita Forres, and this is My Italy. Napoli, let's be real, it's either you love it or you hate it. It doesn't have the beauty of Rome or the charm of Florence. But what it lacks in beauty or charm, it makes up in character. With the mighty Vesuvius looming over the city and the Bay of Naples spread out like a blue carpet before it, Naples certainly captures the imagination. Vedi Napoli e poi muori. See Naples and die, goes the popular Italian saying of unknown origin, which means after one has seen Naples, there is nothing else worth seeing. Today, I would say, eat pizza napoletana and die. Because after having pizza napoletana, no other pizza is worth eating. Maybe I exaggerate, but when you're in the middle of this crazy city that's crazy about pizza, you get the point.
La prossima pizza a Manila.
You also tend to do crazy things like signing up for Enzo Coccia's pizza making boot camp. Enzo Coccia is a master pizzaiolo and certainly one of Napoli's most celebrated. His pizzeria La Notizia was the first to be recommended by the influential Michelin Guide. But what exactly is a Neapolitan pizza?
La pizza napoletana deve essere cotta in 40-50 secondi, deve essere morbida, soffice, deve lievitare per 14-16 ore a temperatura ambiente, deve essere manipolata e stesa con le mani e cotta in un forno a legna.
This morning he is my maestro and I won't lie and say I'm not a teeny bit terrified. We dive right into it. Enzo takes me through the steps right before the pizza goes into the oven. Patrick and Michael, Enzo's legit students, both from the Netherlands, are on their third week.
Uno, due. Colpo secco di volto.
Enzo never takes on more than four students at a time. Any more than that, he says, and you learn nothing. His pizza academy has been described as the Sorbonne of pizza schools.
bravi. Brava. Ok, perfetto. Poi dopo prendi il pomodoro. No, metti la mano così. Prendi la mozzarella con la mano destra, metti con la mano sinistra, metti, prendi il formaggio, prendi il basilico che sta qua, brava, l'olio, soluci. Poi rigolo, bene? Tu dici ok, prendi la pizza di qua, tu sei bravissimo. Uno, due, tre, mettiamo sulla. Ok.
We didn't expect pizza making to be this hard because it took us 2 weeks just to open the oven. Before that, it's just dough, 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 kneading it, making the balls, making the discs, pushing them out, slapping them out.
From Patrick and Michael, I learned that this is a month-long course. Week one is devoted to both theoretical and practical aspects of the impasto, or the all-important dough.
So we were turning some pizzas, but now we're on a 5 minute break to rest our arms a little bit. Yeah, because we have to turn the pizzas without spilling the tomato sauce. So it's a very delicate movement, and it's very, if you keep doing it and doing it and doing it, it's very straining.
There is even a textbook on the course called the Neapolitan Pizza, a scientific guide about the artisanal process by Paolo Massi, Annalisa Romano, and of course, Enzo Coccia.
We're here to learn to make the traditional Neapolitan pizza. First of all, because of the experience, but also maybe we would like to open a pizzeria in the Netherlands.
Week two is all about movement and coordination. This is what they're perfecting now, using the pala to put the dough into the oven, take it out, and rotate. Week three is all about mastering the heat of the oven.
Qua. Allora, girati piano piano e metti qua sopra. Brava. Brava. No, non devi alzare, devi uscire così.
Week four is the only time they make actual pizza. For the final exam, they have to make actual pizza for a panel of judges composed of master pizzaioli. So this is me trying to do a crash course for a 4 week internship in a single morning. Mamma mia! The most famous of Neapolitan pizza is my namesake, Pizza Margherita. The red, the white, and the green is intentional and meant to resemble the Italian flag. It was created by pizzaiolo Raffaele Esposito in 1889 in honor of the visit of Queen Margherita of Savoy to Naples. Today, there are over 800 pizzeria in central Naples, and the most popular pizza is still the Margherita. Of over 800 pizzeria in Naples, only 100 have the coveted Associazione Verace Pizza Napoletana, or APVN accreditation. To be accredited by APVN means that your establishment adheres to the very strict rules of the association. At this point, Enzo is painstakingly teaching me coordination, how to balance the dough on the pala, how to get it in the oven, how to get it out, and onto the serving plate.
Uno, due, uno, due, uno, due. It's a super slight movement of the wrist.
Okay.
due, uno, due. Oops, è caduto. It fell. So while Enzo leaves me to master the art of the pala, he very passionately talks about the universal popularity of pizza napoletana.
La pizza è popolare nel mondo perché diventa un piatto unico di grande qualità. Perché i napoletani amano la pizza? La amano perché all'inizio dell'Ottocento nella città di Napoli già contava 56 pizzerie ed il popolo napoletano mangiava questo prodotto per sfamarsi dalla fame. Quindi è diventato il DNA dei napoletani. Per fare una pizza napoletana di qualità occorre la grande tecnica tradizionale. Occorre dei grandi ingredienti di questa terra, come il pomodoro sammarzano, l'olio d'oliva extravergine d'oliva, la mozzarella di bufala, che addirittura dal 1600 si allevano le bufale in Campania. Occorre un forno a legna che ci abbia delle caratteristiche e che la temperatura sali a 465 gradi. Ma occorre anche l'ingrediente segreto, la passione, l'amore ed il cuore. Una pizza napoletana senza questo non la si può fare. Ed un'altra cosa, non c'è bisogno solo del pizzaiolo napoletano. Anche la pizza napoletana la possono fare tutti nel mondo, se vogliono farla bene.
Uno, due.
Adesso gira.
So we have to learn like the slight movements of using the pala without flipping the pizza and dropping it on the floor. So you have to do like simultaneous, right? Wrist movements on with both hands. Kind of like a dance. It's worse than the gym.
Margarita.
Okay.
The master calls. I think I just got promoted.
So we're like stretching the dough using the four fingers of both hands, but with a little force.
Allora, mano destra, mano sinistra. Uno, due. Uno, due.
Flip and stretch. Flip and stretch.
So by flipping, you're stretching.
Due. Brava. Uno. Questa devi muovere. Allora, ascolta un attimo. Fai senza pizza.
Okay, Enzo says without the dough pizza. First.
Vai. Uno. Gira
anche. Uno.
Due. No, quando
oh my gosh, I'm hopeless. I'll be doing this in my dreams. Uno, due. Uno, due.
Uno, due. Uno, brava. Due. Bene. Uno, due. Uno, due. Ok.
We've done the dough. Now we can do the toppings. Watch how quickly Enzo does it. It's pure muscle memory. Pomodoro San Marzano, mozzarella di bufala, a sprinkle of Parmesan cheese, fresh basil, and extra virgin olive oil quickly poured to form the number 8. Onto the pala, and into the oven. Rotate once, and it's out of the oven in less than 60 seconds.
Pizza Margherita, come
che
te?
Sì, come me.
Margherita,
che
come
ah, Enzo, dai.
Bellissimo. Guarda com'è soffice.
Sì.
È bellissimo, guarda che bei colori.
It's, look allora. At the color, and then look at the crust. It's like moist and soft but with a little bit
allora,
of croccante fuori, no?
Io non parlo inglese. I don't speak English.
No,
only napoletano.
Ok.
Taglia, Margherita.
Ok. Così?
Vai, forte, strong.
Ok. Oh, ho fatto.
Vai. Adesso ce ne hai ripreso un balazo.
Un
allora, adesso che cosa facciamo? Posa qua. Devi prendere come fanno i napoletani.
Ok.
Così.
Così.
Attendo a non scottarti. Aspetta che...
È un po' caldo?
È caliente.
Caldo?
Caldo.
Troppo?
Ok. Buonissimo.
The crust is just so moist, but with a little bit of crunch on the outside. Just the right amount of tomato. And of course, the beautiful mozzarella.
Mozzarella, perfetto. Mozzarella di bufala.
Mozzarella di bufala.
Buffalo mozzarella.
And buffalo mozzarella. All the best of Naples.
Pomodoro San Marzano.
In one slice. Grazie, Enzo.
Prego.
I said it before and I'll say it again. Naples is pizza crazy. And it's not just a tourist thing. Locals love their pizza. Antica Pizzeria Portalba has been around for 200 years and is Naples' oldest pizzeria. Aside from Enzo Coccia's La Notizia, Pizzeria Gino Sorbillo and L'Antica Pizzeria da Michele of Eat, Pray, Love fame are always on the list of best pizzeria, so expect the long line at these places. Pizza in Naples also comes in different varieties. There's fried pizza or pizza fritta, a moon-shaped piece of dough folded to enclose a rich filling of ricotta, salami, and other ingredients, and deep-fried at a high temperature. Watch it as it puffs up. Then there's pizza a portafoglio, which means wallet pizza, because when folded, it resembles a wallet and is meant to be eaten on the go. The art of pizza making in Naples has just recently been awarded UNESCO status as an intangible cultural heritage. And that's a very big deal. Okay, so back to boot camp.
We're making a calzone.
This time, Enzo teaches me how to do a calzone, or an oven-baked folded pizza. He shows me how to fold the dough right in the center. Then, we put in the filling, ricotta, and then salame.
Sì.
Così.
Okay. Perfect.
Okay.
And then some pecorino.
Così.
Brava. Pepe poco.
Poco pepe, just a little pepper.
Poco pomodoro.
Sopra?
Poco. Sì, poco.
Ah, c'hai così.
Guida. Metti il pomodoro, poco, se no non si cuoce. Spiega in inglese.
Ah, you put just a little tomato because if not it won't cook. No?
Sì.
Ok.
Then some fresh basil.
Solo due, così?
Va bene.
Ok.
Pochissimo olio, poco olio, bellissimo.
Just
okay,
a little oil, sorry.
Uno, due, tre, chiudi. Bravo. Bravissima.
So you have to close it well with your fist.
Saldare
bene. Otherwise
bene.
It's going to open while cooking.
Bravissima.
Just a little tomato on top. Così?
Sì, va bene. Vai.
Così?
Se no non si cuoce e devi sfumare.
Because if not, again, it won't cook. And then you spread it on top. Just a thin film of tomato, okay?
Okay. Un po' di mozzarella.
Sì?
Mozzarella, poco.
Sopra?
Sì, ripieno, okay. Calzone napoletano.
Ok.
Un po' di formaggio. Formaggio.
So a little bit of mozzarella and pecorino on the outside.
Perfetto, allora mo devi fare come si fa a Napoli. Dammi pala. Pala, dammi
palla,
pala.
Dammi palla.
Dammi palla. Sì.
Dammi palla.
Ecco.
Ok.
Vai. Farina. Vai. Vai a vedere farina.
Così.
Okay, food. One moment. Bye.
When you cook the calzone, you have to just put it like at the opening of the oven, not all the way inside, because it cooks better with a little bit less heat.
Il calzone, come dice Margherita, si cuoce in 2 minuti. La pizza napoletana si cuoce in 40-50 secondi.
See?
Traduce.
Okay, so the pizza napoletana cooks in 40 to 50 seconds only, but the calzone takes about 2 minutes to cook.
Now it's time to rotate the calzone.
Abbassa un po' la palla, sì? Margherita, mi raccomando, non bruciare la pizza.
Okay, he says, Margherita, please don't burn the pizza.
Dai.
Okay.
Prendi, come ti ho fatto vedere. Piano, gira, un po' la...
E poi, qua?
Brava. Non posare la pala. Guarda sempre là.
Ok.
Per vedere,
ok. Ok.
Uno, due, tre. Finito. Piano. Ok. Piano, piano.
Piano, piano.
Vai, metti qua. Tranquilla. Bellissimo.
Tranquilla, tranquilla.
Vai.
Così?
Sì. Vai. Mamma mia, brava.
Questo
è il calzone napoletano originale 100%.
Wow, the three cheeses mixing together, mozzarella, ricotta, and pecorino, and then the salame. And then, of course, a little tomato and the basil, and of course, the beautiful crust. They just all go well together. Yummy calzone.
Uno, due. Grazie. Grazie, Enzo. Sei numero uno.